smells of some of the same stuff that the Chicanos faced in the 60s in getting recognition and getting better conditions for their schools. It's a similar thing. So it's just an opportunity, I think, to remember history and to not repeat the mistakes. I think you, when you have a designation for something, a monument to honor someone like Mr. Castro, you absolutely stop what you're doing and you honor that. You know, there's no question about that for me. From, again, what I've studied so far, just learning about the issue, and I'm new on the education committee who's brought this forth for later on the agenda and the motion. So I really support the motion. I think you've got to sometimes stop what is in quotes called progress. And just stop, remember, pause. I think a lot of people here look like they're supportive. I hope we support the monument to Sal Castro and preserving Castro Park, which has its environmental concerns as well. Thank you.
Anybody else would like to speak? A public comment?
Yeah.
Card? You have a card?
Here, doesn't it?
In the agenda, you cannot make a public comment.
No, that one is not that.
Can you announce your name
again? Peter Galindo.
Peter.
Who has a part? President has a part? President has a part?
Are you related to the Galindo that do the high wire thing?
No.
I and it's never even had a 100th celebration. And us as a community, we're going to be celebrating on our own part with our own funds with people volunteering on the 14th. We're going to call it, you know, that has a park celebration and it's going to be amazing because that's how important the park is. It was dedicated to him. Then on the other side, there's a monument right there. It was dedicated also to Mayor Villalobos, you know, because of the 100 trees that they, the million trees that they wanted to carry. So we got the Whitman, we got El Castro, we have Mayor, the Queen's Mayor, and we have Antonio who just said. So the thing is, like, forget history, just bury it, just go to the hospital, that's not right. That's not right, and I really hope that you take that direction when it does come up.
Have an idea or areas where we could go ahead and install bus benches and
charge of that, because right here where the auto zone is, the Huntington Drive,
yes.
It is always full, 7 days a week. That sucker's always full. And over there on Maycrest where the barbershop is, it's always full, you know? And so who is responsible
for that? So part of what we're gonna do with, so again, there's some trash receptacles that are picked up by street services, and there are others contracting agency. So our job is going to be, now that we're going to be installing these new trash receptacles, to coordinate our schedule. So we know when it's going to be picked up and when it's not. We know that when it's picked up, it's a matter of placing a call.
Yes. In regard to the bus furniture or street furniture, right? It'll come under that category we're talking about here.
Yes.
I think most people notice the proliferation of new bus benches and, you know, citywide. But also the advertising on those benches derives a revenue, which is shared with the company that puts them out, but it's also shared back to the city. And I was wondering if the councilman would entertain some thoughts about funding certain amenities within the neighborhood council jurisdiction. We had a discussion with members of some of the neighborhood councils in West LA, and for example, in CD 11, the neighborhood councils have worked out an agreement within Councilman Rosenthal to give a percentage of the money to the neighborhood council for various activities for the street furniture fund. So we wonder if Councilman Weezer maybe set up a percentage of the revenue that can come into CD 14, not only for the neighborhood council, but for other community organizations, whether it's the art center that may need some funding, or the Stallions football team, or the public schools within the area. So if something like that could be done with some of the revenue in the future, would that's something maybe you could report back on next month?
Yeah, if there's already something that's been done in the council district, that's something that we're open to looking at, and if it's successful in CD 11, why would it not be successful here in CD 14?
One more thing.
Yes.
The parklet in front of Food for Less and on Huntington Drive here in El Sereno, filthy.
Yes.
Okay, practically since they built it, because it gets a lot of use, and it also gets a lot of use from homeless people, which I have no problem. Glad they have a place where they can congregate and nobody bottle or rob them or whatever. It's safe for them and they can eat from that truck that's there in the afternoon. But there's no maintenance. I understand they pull some of the panels you have there and beautify it. It's unfortunate, you know. But still, it's filthy. It's poor. It's just that asshole you want to throw up.
No, so with that, yes, I know there are concerns related to the parklet. It was something that has worked in certain parts of the district, and it's something that's, you know, we're working to alleviate and fix some of these issues related to the park in El Sereno. But yes, we were working with LAPD to go out there, be out there, be vigilant. Our agency that we're working with, the school agencies, it's Cleaning Green and Fuego Tech, have gone out and are the ones that are going to be clean. But yes, we're currently revising and looking at the use of the parklet, and we're open to suggestions.
If that could be steam clean, that would help immensely. Now that's one place where it should be steam clean,
yes,
in terms of the sidewalk in the parking.
So that's something that that Northeast Graffiti Busters does for us in the council this year. So that's something that they will start doing in terms of steam cleaning car wash, not the parking.
Thank you, sir.
Oh, but before I go, this is a little
Hello?
Bit long overdue.
Hello?
I hope it's okay.
Hello?
So I have certificates, again, like I said, they're long overdue. This is specifically an acknowledgement for celebration and the 54th annual of Sereno Bicentennial Parade. At first, individual, Violeta Urbina.
That's our president for the bicentennial.
I'll be have insurance by January. So this is a great opportunity to explore your options for insurance. Again, our first one is September 21st at Griffith Middle School in East LA, and the second one will be October 19th in Highland Park. I'll be needing flyers for the East LA Health Fair in the back as well. And in addition to that, the current mayor, Mr. Garcetti, has went ahead and extended the Million Trees LA initiative. So we've partnered with him at Million Trees LA, and we'll be doing our second tree giveaway at Food for Less on October 5th. We'll be handing out flyers via mail for El Sereno, so we hope you can attend. The max trees we can get are 200, and the last tree giveaway we did in Highland Park, we gave away 100 trees an hour. So 200 trees went in 2 hours. The trees are pretty large. They're about 5 feet, so almost high height. Fruit trees, very bountiful, and we hope you can attend. Again, that's on a first-come, first-served basis. That's October 5th, starting at 9 a.m. So those flyers, I'll have these nice ones for you the next neighborhood council meeting. Otherwise, you'll be getting them in the mail as well.
Can you forward them to me so I can deliver them?
Yes, thank you.
As you probably are aware, we have some planters. They have no plants on Huntington Drive. Quite a few of them are empty. Some of the businesses that have them have done some ones. So between the beautification committee, the chair here, and myself, the green committee, which I'm the chair, we're trying to partner for some money so we can have those plots moved to where people want them and maintain them. When the time comes to put dirt in trees, I want to ask you if you can get together with your office at that time, whenever that is, down the road in time, and maybe you can get us some trees to put in those pots. It helped me at least from 5 gallons to larger, so they won't be that easy to steal. As you know, on the park, they try several times to replace plants for trees and they've been taken.
I'd be more than happy to talk about that then. As far as this tree giveaway, you do have to bring a utility bill or a driver's license because it's practically a tree adoption where they're asking, or Million Trees LA is asking us to plant it if you're around home. So that's how that event is working. And lastly, as part of Assembly Member Jimmy Gomez's Breakfast Club event, he'll be hosting a breakfast club with Matt Faber, who's the legislative analyst. And the legislative analyst is a nonpartisan fiscal and policy analysis office, primarily dealing with nonprofits and so forth. He analyzes the budget and whatever fiscal impacts we have on a nonpartisan basis. And this breakfast club will be held at Grifols, which is also now Sereno's, lots of events now Sereno. Grifols is the plasma plant at the end of the 710 freeway. So this event is also limited spacing, but again, all of our events are free. And our flyers, we have all the information to RSVP. So we'd love to see you at the breakfast club. We provide a light continental breakfast and get a one-on-one environment for you and the assembly member, as well as our guest speaker, which will be the California legislative analyst. That is October 11th. So I'll also be sending all of these dates to Connie, and for everything that I do have to offer hard copies for, which is 3 out of 4 events, I'll be putting in the back as well. And in any case, feel free to always contact me. And lastly, I would also like to give up to the Directing Commission on behalf of the Governor of the Gomez and the California State Assembly for those who participated in the parade. I'm going to do it a little different than Julio and call everyone at once, and if you can say your applause for the end, that would be great. Thank you. So Violeta Urbina, Ruben Chavez, Maria Elena Garcia, Jenny Guerrero, Calvinet, Quecho Mexico, Rocky Income Tax Professional Services, and Roxana Mesa. Again, thank you guys. Roxy? Okay.